All right, welcome back. Okay, pen and ink time with hatching and cross-hatching techniques. So as we practiced the other day, hatching our marks done in one direction. Let's demonstrate here with a pen. We'll talk about those in a minute. So hatch marks are done in one direction, done quickly and closely spaced. I can space them farther apart, especially for when you are working with number two here. You're gonna have to use a very fine tipped pen and you will have to space them out a bit. Otherwise it will read too dark. So unlike a pencil where we can vary pressure, while I can lighten up pressure with a pen, it is not going to get that much lighter. It's black ink. So the nib size is very fine on this one. This is a 0.3. Oh, I should probably talk about that. So we're going to use various drawing pens. A 1.0, a 0.8, a 0.5, 0.3. I do want to caution you with the little ones especially. They're extremely delicate. These markers are not cheap. They're like $3 or $4 a piece. If you break it, I'm not going to be super happy with you. So be gentle. And please do not steal them. I need them back. Kids have to use them. I know you like my markers, but I like them too. And so does everyone else. Leave them in the box. Okay. So hatching with a very thin pen. You can see how much lighter it is than the one I did with the 0.5. I believe I did that. This is a 0.3. If I push a little harder, it will go darker. So back your hand up a little bit. Let the weight of the pen do the mark. You just swing it back and forth, okay? So this is how we will achieve some of the lighter areas, like number two and number three. All right. Hatching is one way. Cross-hatching is, as the name implies, you cross them. These can be curved marks, or they can be straight. Since we are using square, we're filling in squares, we are most likely going to use what line? Straight or curved? You guessed it. Straight. All right, so let's look at our example here. Here it is. All right, so I started number five already. I'm going to use a number, either a 0.8 or a 1.0. I'm just going to go to 1.0. The pens are also, they're labeled on the cap. They're labeled on the body of the pen. If they always trust the one on the body more than the cap, please, if you have a bunch of these on your table, put the right cap on. All right, so you can see I started this. I'm going to start by going around the edges. Go around the edges carefully. Make a little border for yourself so you can bump up to it. I can make my hatch marks short or long or both. Since it's going to be pretty dark, so say if this was your corner here, I'm going to make some straight marks along the edge. Okay. Get space them out a little bit. And I'm just going to fill in with some smaller hatch marks. Going one way, go another way. Okay. I'm not going to spend the whole time with this video blocking it in. I'm just going to show you. You want to get about yay dark, okay? In this corner here, I can probably fill in some of those little spots a little bit more. All right. So to get to number four, let's just say I pretend I finished five. It will match this, okay, or be a little darker than that, but close. Again, it's the relative spacing. So if my five is a little darker than this on the paper that I'm drawing on, then my four is going to be a little darker than you see here as well. All right, it's relative distance. For this box, I used a 0.5, I believe. Yes. And then again, now we got to match the four. So I'm just going to do a little corner over here. I'll stop the video and show you it finished. So you can see it. I'm getting close. That little corner is pretty close to the four. I'm gonna keep this here. One thing you might want to do too is you got a lot of graphite from shading. If you want to keep a little piece of scrap paper over there to remind you not to run your hand through it, you can. I might turn this paper around. So if I'm sticking my hand over the graphite, put a little piece of paper underneath so you don't smear. Okay, so you have, just like shading with the pencil, you had to work light and slowly bring it up to the darker value that you wanted to achieve. With the pen too, you want to start light, So let the weight of the pen do the work. Don't push too hard. Just kind of drag it across. Hatch marks, cross hatch, leave some space, slowly fill in to make it darker. You can erase pencil. You cannot erase the pen. I am going to assess your careful mark making and matching value. Okay, so I completed the 5 and 4 values. You will notice that the pen is darker than the print. So with that consideration again, it's the relative values in comparison to one another. So if my 5 is darker than this 5, then my 4 has to be darker than this 4. We want about the same jump between the two. One thing I noticed, I started on the top, not the bottom, but that's okay. I can still blend through these. It's actually not a bad way to do it if you want to shade both. Kind of get double practice. And I also wrote the pens I used here, and I also wrote the pencils I used up here. So I know you may or may not remember that, but I remember, and if you did what I did, you used 4B, 6B here, and you used 2B, 4B here, you used HB, 2B here, H and HB here. Here I used the 1.0, 0.5, 0.8 nibs, 0.3 and 0.3. One thing I noticed, there's a lot of white. So if you wanna cheat a little bit, you can take like an HB pencil. And this just kind of evens it out. It's not really cheating. You're still gonna see the pen hatch marks, but this is gonna push back the white of the paper a bit. Kind of sort of mellow things out. So you can see it's just lightly, I'm not pushing too hard. And don't use a dark pencil. Use HB is fine. Okay, you can kind of shade the white in a little bit. And I said never use your fingers, but here you can use your finger. Just lightly. And I'm starting to get some smudge marks on my paper. So you can clean that with your kneaded eraser, okay? Just clean as you go. All right, so number three. Let's label these. HB pencil, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So I'm gonna use a 0.3. I'm gonna keep this here so I can see as I'm working. I already started this one. It's kind of close, might be a little darker, but again, my 3 is darker and my 4 is darker. I'm sorry, my 5 and my 4 are darker, so my 3 is going to be a little darker than here too, okay? So start, keep your pen, your hand back off the pen, and go close to the edges, right? Just block it in slowly. My hatch marks are kind of messy. If you prefer them more uniform, you may do that. So just kind of block it in, and then you're going to slowly bring it up. As you get closer, a little bit more than this, you can kind of shade in a little bit. Just kind of block in some of the white. Okay, blending. I did top and bottom the same, and actually it's not a bad way to do it. I wish I thought of that earlier with the top, with graphite, but we do have to finish it up. So we're going to create that even gradation. I would think about the pens you use similarly. I'm going to put this over the graphite just to kind of cover it, and also so I can see my reference. The trick is to use the pen and then slowly blend those edges out. I'm gonna start a little thinner. I might not use the one. I might just go to like a 0.5, to be honest with you, and just see there. I'm gonna go conservative and see if I need to go heavier. Go to the edge. You're gonna kind of blend it with hatch marks and or cross hatch marks. I'm gonna go to 0.3. Again, you can turn your paper. I don't have a lot of room on my table at the moment, so it's a little awkward. Soften those edges up. I am not a super neat crosshatcher. You don't have to be either. But if you do like nice precise lines, try it. See if you can do it. Soften up your edges, right? This one, be very careful. Squint your eye. I have a dark spot there. That's a problem. I can't fix it. Start over, Porter. Be careful. I can make this darker, but then it's really close to my 5. Oh, that's a boo-boo. This is why talking while I'm working is not a good idea, because we can't multitask well. Okay, well, sometimes I show you what not to do. Okay. Slowly, steadily, be careful, all right? Good luck. I thought I would try this. Here's a little hack. You can try to erase some of these thinner marks. They will lighten up a little bit. Be careful you're not like rubbing so hard that you abrade your paper though, okay? So you can lighten up. So the dark area that I made, I could have tried to lighten up a little bit. And then you can also kind of blend a little bit with a graphite pencil if you need to, okay? All right.